No, I am not debating right or wrong. I am simply stating a fact.
Enough! Do you think you understand the Lord of Geo more than me? Episode 5!
Everything you have, everything you are, you've got to give. On the battlefield, when everything is chaos, and you have nothing but the way you feel, your strategy and a sword, you just think about the life you'll have together after the war. And then you do it for her. That's how you know you can win. You do it for her, that is to say, you'll do it for him.
My foot.
What?
In times gone by, one quarreled oft with Guizhong concerning mechanical principles. We each had our ideals, and neither would yield. Under the pretext of a social gathering, one invited the impartial Rex Lapis to judge the quality of our creations. But Rex Lapis declared that Guizhong's obscuro vulpus mechanism was superior. Though one was too proud to acknowledge it, in one's heart, one knew that Guizhong was indeed the superior talent in the mechanical arts. As for the story between Guizhong and Streetward Rambler, that begins with a certain bell. In Guizhong's opinion, while mechanisms were no substitute for human composers, they were yet capable of producing simple but fine melodies. But Streetward Rambler believed music to be an expression of the soul, an emotional enterprise that could never hope to be replicated by machinery. They argued endlessly, until one asked Rex Lapis to intercede. He confiscated the bell and designated it for ceremonial use. Thereafter, one would often find them convening in the mountains, discussing music, mechanics, and all the affairs of the mortal world. But these good times were not to last. War broke out between the gods, and soon engulfed the Guili Plains. Guizhong was overpowered by the enemy, and fell in battle. When Streetwood Rambler and I arrived at the scene at long last, all that remained among the ruins was her lifeless body. After this, at Streetwood Rambler's request, Rex Lapis granted her the cleansing bell for safekeeping. To honor our friend's memory, one made a few finishing touches to her ballistic device. Many lantern rites have passed since then. Many greetings and goodbyes. Upon what do you gaze? The Guili Plains?
No. It's everything. We think of human life as like a lantern that's lit 1 minute and extinguished the next. But are we adepti so different? Perhaps as dust settles after a storm, we too must one day return to the world below.
Watching as you entered Xinyue Kiosk, but no one seemed to notice me. Did I say that it's because I'm an expert in hiding, or that a certain someone deliberately ignored the sound of the wind?